Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Glancer Kappa, and I am a core member of the OWASP ZAP development team and the lead on the Jenkins plugin project. For those unfamiliar with the project, the OWASP Z Attack Proxy, or ZAP for short, is a free security tool which is actively maintained by volunteers such as myself. It can help you automatically find security vulnerabilities in your web applications while you are developing and testing them. Please keep in mind that this video is not a training video on how to use ZAP itself, but rather to demonstrate how to integrate ZAP into a continuous integration environment using the Jenkins automation server. It is highly recommended that you understand some ZAP terminology such as session management, what a context is, what a spider scan is, how to perform an active scan, and finally, please see the description below for more information on what ZAP is, what it does, and how to use it. This video will be split into three segments: the installation, setup, and running phases of each required application. In this case, we need a compatible version of Jenkins, a usable version of Firefox, which is compatible with the Selenium driver, and a working version of ZAP. We will cover each setup phase for each application, and finally, we will set up a Jenkins job and execute ZAP from it to perform a passive, spider scan in this case, and an active scan. The plugin takes full advantage of the ZAP API and provides features such as session management, the ability to load or persist sessions. You will be able to define a context by providing a unique name, including the URL specific to that context, or excluding URLs from the context. Not only that, but you will be able to passively map your site using the spider scan or Ajax spider. You will also be able to raise active alerts by performing an active scan. Not only that, but we support form and script-based authentication methods. The key takeaway here is that not only will you be able to automate your vulnerability scans, but you will be able to integrate ZAP as part of your functional testing. Using your Selenium scripts, while ZAP acts as an intercepting proxy, recording and mapping the structure of your site and performing a spider and active scan afterwards. This will turn your functional testing into vulnerability testing. Finally, you will be able to generate HTML, XML, and JSON reports for use by the developer or management. Let's take a look at the workflow of ZAP as a part of a continuous integration environment. We have Jenkins sitting at the very top. It will initialize a ZAP build step. Traffic will flow through ZAP, which is acting as an intercepting proxy, and it will hit the target application or server with ZAP modified requests to include vulnerability tests. The application server will send a response back. ZAP will receive the response, and then ZAP will send back the response data, all the alerts, to Jenkins, as well as reporting data. Jenkins, in this case, will take the reports, archive them into the build, and publish the HTML, XML, or JSON reports. It's important to note that these reports are fully customizable, and Jenkins is also able to support the creation of Jira tickets for each alert. Now that you have an understanding of how ZAP fits into a continuous integration environment with Jenkins as the automation server, you will go to the Jenkins home site and download the desired WAR file. In my case, I'm using the LTS, the long-term stable release. Create a Jenkins folder and extract the now downloaded WAR file into it. After which you will create a Jenkins home environment variable and point it to the Jenkins folder. You can use the following command from the command line to start Jenkins. Jenkins will require and ask you which plugins you wish to install. Simply take the recommended. After Jenkins is installed, up and running, and you have logged in, go to the Manage Plugins and download the Environment Injector plugin, the Summary Display plugin, the HTML Publisher plugin, and the ZAP Jenkins plugin. Once you have finished and installed Jenkins, it is time to download and install a release of ZAP. Currently, only weekly releases are supported after September 5th, 2016. The 2.5 standard release does not work with the ZAP Jenkins plugin. However, the future 2.6 standard release will be the benchmark. Once you have downloaded your desired weekly release, create a ZAP folder and extract the file from the zip file into it. Create a ZAP proxy home environment variable pointing to the folder you just created. In the folder, there will be a file called zap.bat. Modify the file such that the jar file will always be pointed to the ZAP proxy home directory. At which point, once all of these steps are done, you can start ZAP from the command line with the following command seen on the screen. It is also worth mentioning that you should potentially increase the amount of RAM allocated to ZAP. After having finished all your configurations for ZAP, Firefox, and Jenkins, as well as any additional settings that you wish to change, you may now decide how you wish to map your website. You can do this manually via the ZAP UI, or you can write a Selenium script to configure the job, and then execute this as part of a ZAP Selenium build. For the purpose of this tutorial, we will be doing it manually. After you have finished mapping your website manually and persisted this session, as well as created a new job in Jenkins and run it one time to create the workspace, you will want to take your persisted session and move it into your job's workspace. This will give visibility to the ZAP Jenkins plugin so that you are able to load the persisted session. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your time. I've included some documentation here, links to the wiki page. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them on the Google group. Issue tracking will be done on the Jenkins Jira. Please follow the Jira guidelines before you report an issue. Your feedback will drive our future development and determine which features we focus on. Thank you very much.